Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunke and welcome to the x86 assembly course. Till now, we have seen the necessary theory and instructions. From now on, the real fun begins. So, let's get started. In this video, we are going to convert C program to its assembly code. Let's look at our C program first. This is our C program. First, we are including stdio.h file. After that, we will go to the main and our program execution will begin there. Next, we are calling function. Function starts from here. Function returning with value 22222222. And as we have seen previously, closing curly brackets means function ends here. So function have ended and we have returned to the main, and now execution resume from main, and main is returning with value 11111111. Closing curly bracket means main ends here. Let's debug our program in Visual Studio. This is our program. First, we will click here to set a breakpoint. After that, we will debug the program. To debug, click on this play icon. And now right click anywhere and click on go to disassembly. So this is our assembly code language for its equivalent C code. Let's look at our C program and assembly code in a simpler form. This is our C program and its equivalent assembly code. In the right hand side, we have our stack here. ESP is pointing to address 0012FF6C and that has a value 0040128. That value belongs to the function who called main, so that value is known as saved return address. We will start our execution from main. First instruction in our assembly language is at address 00401010 and EIP is pointing there. The instruction is push EBP, that means we are pushing stack frame pointer of a previous initialization function who called main. EBP is 0012FFB8 and that will get pushed onto the stack. Next instruction is used to move address pointed by the ESP into the EBP to set main function's stack frame. So address pointed by the ESP is 0012FF68 and that will get pushed into EBP, and from now on this is a main's stack frame. For every function, compiler will generate these two lines, push EBP and move ESP into EBP to set stack frame for that function. As we saw earlier, the next line in C code is we are calling function. Let's see its assembly equivalent. This is a call instruction. To pass control to another function, we use a call instruction, and for that, next instruction's address will be get pushed onto the stack first. So next instruction's address is 00401018. That will get pushed onto the stack. Why we are doing that? Because when function finishes its execution, it will be used as a return address to return to the main. In this case, when function finishes its execution, it will return on 00401018 and from that instruction, main will resume its execution. Now we are executing from function 1 and EIP is pointing to 00401000. Now just think what will happen when new function start. As we have seen earlier, the compiler will first set its stack frame onto the stack. For that, it will first push main's stack frame pointer, which is saved into the EBP, onto the stack, and it will move address pointed by ESP into the EBP to start function stack frame. So the first instruction is push EBP. After that, what we'll do? Will move address pointed by the ESP into the EBP. Okay, so now EBP's value is 0012FF60, and from this address, function stack frame has started. Okay, so now let's look at our stack. On stack, there are total 3 stack frames of 3 different functions. This is for initialization function. This stack frame is for main, and this is function stack frame. Next line in C code is we are returning with 2s. So let's see its assembly equivalent. So first we will save those 2s into the EAX. So function has finished its execution. For that, first we'll pop value and put that into the EBP to give main its own stack frame pointer. Okay. Next is a return instruction. Let's recall what is a return instruction is. Return instruction is used to return from one function to another, and for that we will pop the value from stack and put that into the EIP. The value on a stack is 00401018. We will put that value into the EIP. And as we can see, EIP has returned to the main. So the 00401018 was stored onto the stack, and we pop that value into the EIP, and EIP has returned to the main using that address. Next line of a C code is return with ones. For that, first we will move the ones into the EAX. Now EAX contains ones. This is a form of a move instruction. We are moving immediate value into the register. Closing curly bracket means main ends here. For that, what we'll do? First, we will give back the function who called main its own stack frame pointer. Yes, you're right. That is stored onto the stack. So we will move value from stack into the EBP. Okay. Pop instruction, pop top of the stack into the EBP. Next is a return instruction. We will return to the function who called main. How will we do that? Yes, for that we will take value from the stack, put that into the EIP, and program execution will begin from there. Okay, that's all for this video. We are going to see a lot of examples with different options in the upcoming videos, so you will understand everything crystal and clear. But if you had any problem understanding what is a push, pop, move, return, call, or how stack works, or what is a general stack frame layout, then please go and watch my previous videos. Here you will find all the videos in x86 assembly course. And if you have any doubts, any questions, you can contact me on following handles. Thank you.